remind you, you're more than welcome to take photos, but please, no flash. Birdland is proud to present the Louis Armstrong Eternity Band, directed by David Ostwald.
Thank you. Thank you and good night. You guys know better. What I meant to say was thank you and welcome to the stunningly beautiful Birdland Theater. We are the Louis Armstrong Eternity Band. It's just a stage you're going through. We are the Louis Armstrong Eternity Band, here for your listening pleasure. Thanks for coming out to hear us this beautiful evening. I'd like to introduce you to the members of our orchestra. On my far left, your far right, I speak not politically necessarily, from Cleveland, Tennessee, ladies and gentlemen, Jim Fryer. From Chinchilla, Pennsylvania, the killer from Chinchilla on trumpet, Joe Boga. On clarinet and alto saxophone, on loan from the National Football League, ladies and gentlemen, Peyton Manning. Yeah. Actually, it's Will Anderson from Bethesda, Maryland. Hey, Peyton got all that applause. They did. There's nothing. Radio silence. I'll try it again. He's actually Will Anderson from Bethesda, Maryland. Woo! What a night. All right. Over here on banjo and guitar is a young man who needs no introduction.
Hello.
On drums from Chappaqua, New York, ladies and gentlemen, Alex Raderman. Yes, the Alex Raderman. How about that, folks? Oh, that's all you got? All right. That'll get you a mini introduction. Okay, that's how it works in the big city, folks. Anyway, this young man really, truly does not need an introduction. I can say unequivocally that of all the banjo players on West 44th Street on Wednesdays at 5:30, between 8th and 9th Avenue, that is, this young man is definitely one of them. How about that?
All right.
I speak the truth. It also so happens that he's a fantastic musician and I thought I heard something. It's hearing voices again. Stop it. He also happens to be a fantastic singer and a fantastic banjo player. Ladies and gentlemen, from Vancouver, British Columbia, how about a nice hand for Arnie Arnson? Yeah. My name is David Ostwald. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. I will be your tuba player this evening. I'm from Swarthmore, Pennsylvania. Thank you. Please remain seated. Please remain seated. Thank you. For now, at least. All right. We're going to keep it rolling. We're going to do a beautiful tune written by the great Duke Ellington for Louis Armstrong. We'd like to dedicate this to our friend Dave at the bar there, who celebrated a birthday since he was last here. And this is one of his favorite tunes and one of ours. It's called Azalea.
A fine spring day down Louisiana way, with such fragrance divine, and and such magnificent regalia. Also fine azalea. Oh, what a lovely sight in red and pink and white. You know, I just can't help but believe, baby, that nothing evil can assail ya. You're just so naive, azalea. You're at ease on the knees of the moss covered trees. Those tops mean to make a high ceiling in the church like palm of that cypress swamp. I'd get to find that same strange feeling. I've got to go back there and find my blossom fair that I've been dreaming of. For who on earth could be a failure? You're my very first love, azalea.
How about that Joe Boga on the trumpet? Yeah. Woo! And of course, Arnie Arntzen on the vocal. Woo! All right, folks, as I said earlier, we are the Louis Armstrong Eternity Band. We're here every Wednesday, 5:30 p.m. at the stunningly beautiful Birdland Theater. We are now in our 24th year every week. Pretty good. Every Wednesday for
That's
24 years.
Gig,
That's a steady gig, yeah. 2 weeks in a row is a steady gig. Anyway, but I urge you to check out the schedule because there's a lot of great music happening here all the time, 6, 7, 8, 9, sometimes even 10 nights a week. Not only here, but upstairs, so check it out. Food is great, the vibe is great, everything's great about Birdland, especially the music. So please do check out the schedule or the schedule if you're from across the pond. All right. We're going to, we got a lot of talent up here. We're going to unleash it like a little bit at a time. Right now, we're going to treat you to the vocal stylings of our trombone player, the great Jim Fryer, on a tune that Louis Armstrong recorded with his Hot Five back in 1926 or so, for those of you taking historical notes. It's called Butter and Egg Man.
Ah, all right. All right.
Thank you. We got some.
It's the American Dairy
Association. High cholesterol. All right. So let's do with second, whenever you want to sing it. And we'll do two out. Full pulse.
Yeah, I'll not the second chorus, but somewhere
down
the line.
In there.
Yeah.
Rehearsal's over. One, two. another vocal from Jim Fryer. How about that? I told you. I warned you. All right, we're going to do another tune right now that was written by the great Duke Ellington. It appeared on the one record that Louis Armstrong and Duke Ellington made together. It was in the early 1960s. It's still available if you want to check it out. It's called Louis Armstrong and Duke Ellington, Together for the First Time. Took a committee of 12 to come up with that title. It's called Cottontail.
All right, lightly, brightly, two flats.
Thank you.
What a night. All right, Cantel featuring the ensemble. I speak French, see? Did you guys know that?
Yeah. No.
Repertoire, raconteur, Chevrolet, cigarette, genre. Did I say that one? Anyway, we are going to give Joe and Jim a little breather right now and feature our wonderful reed man, Mr. Not Peyton Manning, whose birthday it is today, by the way. How about that? And what's really amazing, Will has a twin brother, Pete. They've got a great band called, used to be the Anderson Twins, but they're still twins, but now they're called the Anderson Brothers. And they've got the same birthday, which is really, how often does that happen? Pretty amazing, pretty amazing. By the way, when I was your age, I was 37. Amazing how that works. What you got, Pops?
I'd like to do a song that we didn't rehearse.
Well, that narrows it down to everything.
Let's do that. This is by UB Blake. It's called Memories of You.
By who?
UB Blake.
No, I'd be David. Thank you.
Will Anderson, ladies and gentlemen. All right, we're going to keep it rolling. We're going to have Arnie. I think it's time for Arnie to sing another tune. What do you say, folks? Yeah. Let's try it again. Let's have Arnie sing another one. What do you say, folks? Woo! What a night. I love his singing. I know you do as well. This one was written by the great Isham Jones, and it's called I'll See You in My Dreams. We actually might have a duet on this one. Jim Fryer's going to sing it. Why don't you sing it and you sing behind him? Let's try that. You're not yet. Then you have to switch places with Alex. We're going to try a little experiment. All right. We're going to have two guys sing at the same time. Let's see what happens. I'll see you in my dreams.
We're going to do one flat.
You got
the
notes.
We're going to go to the second chorus.
Okay.
One, two, one, two. Thank you. Sorry, I got all excited.
All right, how about that? Beautiful, that double vocal there, I think it worked. What do you say, folks? Yeah. Nothing like a double vocal.
That's right.
All right, I have another question for you, if you don't mind taking a brief survey. You ready? Are you having fun or what?
I think the microphone's
broken.
Turn it up to 11.
It's
one louder.
Maybe I should turn it up to 11.
It's one louder.
You having fun or what? Actually, thank you very much. I appreciate that. But we can feel it even if you don't make a whole lot of noise. But we're flattery operated, so the more noise you make, the more therapy sessions we can skip this week. And that saves us money. Those co-pays add up, right, guys? So I think they saved us about maybe $900 collectively just now with all that applause. All right, we do appreciate it. All right, we're going to do a tune right now. We haven't played for a while. We don't play it too often. You don't hear it too often either, and there's no reason for it. We love to play it when we do. It's recorded by Louis Armstrong in the 1920s with his Hot Five. It's called King of the Zulus.
All right, Dog Minor.
Thank you.
That tune. What do you say, folks? Should we keep it in the book?
Yeah!
I love it. All right. We're going to play another one from around the same period, a little later in the 1930s. It was named after a venue that Louis Armstrong used to play in New Orleans as a young man. It's called the Mahogany Hall Stomp.
Thank you.
What a night. All right, Mahogany Hall Stomp, featuring, once again, the ensemble. Oui, oui. All right, we're going to do a tune right now that we're going to have. I think it's time for Arnie to do another vocal. What do you say, folks?
Yeah,
I'm just aching for one. Unfortunately, time goes so fast. We only got time for a couple more tunes, but I do want to make sure we got to sneak in another soggy ballad from, especially since it's raining out, from Arnie here. This one, it's about Wisconsin, for those of you who follow politics in America. For those of you who don't, never mind. But this one's about Wisconsin. It's called Am I Blue?
Thank you. Very charitable.
Three flats.
What are we in? Three flats?
Yeah, three flats.
Right? Just for a change.
Yeah.
A change of menu. Sing it whenever you feel like it. Second chorus or later, whatever.
Sure.
One, two,
with your man has done fell through.
tonight, Arnie Arntzen and My Blue. Actually, it looks like we got a little more time than I thought. So I will do two things. The first of which is to tell you that we do have CDs for sale, which I didn't even bring that up. Does anyone remember what CDs are?
This is the last CD store in New York. You know?
This is, I guess, the last CD store in New York. Well, they're little silver discs that you stick in a machine, and they play recorded music. And we have one from a live concert we did a few years back that actually Frank Vignola's on it. Frank is going to be here after us at 8:30 for Guitar Night. You might want to look into that, because Frank is simply the greatest guitar player alive today, in my opinion. And he's right here every Wednesday at the stunningly beautiful Birdland Theater. He's got some special guests tonight, including, who's here, Matt Munisteri, John Kelso's here. It's going to be fun. Anyway, Frank is on this record that was made a few years back in a live concert, much like this evening where Wild Abandon filled the air. It was so thick that night. It was as thick as it is tonight. You can cut it with a knife. See the Wild Abandon everywhere? It's there. It's there, yeah. It's all over the place. Anyway, we are offering it for your purchase right back there at the front desk, and I think that you'll enjoy it. There are many, many reasons to buy our CD. There's no greater way of showing the depth of your love for your loved one than with the gift of one or two or three dozen of our CDs. They make great stocking stuffers. When it comes around to Christmas, you may have a birthday coming up or something. We got some holiday coming. Oh, we got Purim, we got Passover, Good Friday, Easter. It's a great way to celebrate by buying one or two or three dozen of our CDs. And they do come with a guarantee. I don't know if you've ever heard of this guarantee. It's a very unique one. If you don't like it, send it back to me, and I'll send you a CD that I don't like.
That's fair.
I've got a whole pile of them at home that I'm looking to get rid of, but I doubt you'll want to do that should you choose to purchase it. Anyway, all right. So we'd like to thank you extremely for coming out to hear us this evening. We had a great time playing for you. We're here every Wednesday. As I said, isn't Birdland the greatest place in the world to hear music, right? Woo! The food is great. The drinks are great. Everything. The service, what a vibe. We love it here. So thanks for coming. We do hope to see you again. And we're going to leave you now, as we always do, with a Louis Armstrong composition from the year 1936. Here's Swing That Music. Good night, folks. Thank you. Yes, folks, as the sun sets over West 44th Street, it's time to say goodnight. Thank you once again for coming out to hear us. Until next time, how about one more hand for these incredibly talented musicians up here, including, without limitation, Jim Fryer, Joe Boga, Will Anderson, Arnie Arnson, Alex Raderman, and yours truly, David Ostwald, reminding you that if you're driving tonight, please make sure you have a car.
Those of you who like the stereo,